In this video, I'm going to show you a demonstration, another application performance scenario for Azure SQL. But this time, we're going to get a little different footprint for the problem we're running into, and we're going to get a slightly different solution than we did last time when we scaled our application by changing vCores in Azure SQL. So back again, we're looking at the familiar tool SQL Server Management Studio, and you're looking at a table that I created in addition to what's already in the AdventureWorks sample called Order Rating. And what we're going to do is we're going to run a small little O-stress test to insert a bunch of rows into this table. In fact, our query looks something like this. Just going to be a loop, 500 times, running a bunch of inserts against this table. So I'm going to kick it off and see what behavior I get. So I'm going to run here, and then I'm going to go use DMV queries like you use in your SQL Server environment, like DM exec request, to look at what I see. And what do I see? I see a bunch of wait types with write log, usually indicative of some sort of IO latency problem. I'll look at another DMV you're used to seeing. How about DMOS wait stats? If I look here, I can see write log floating up as one of the top waits I've got. Remember our scenarios we talked about? This is a waiting scenario, an IO wait called write log, which indicates perhaps transaction log latency. We also talked about another DMV. We can look at IO latencies in SQL Server through IO virtual file stats. And I run this, I can see the average delay latency is about 2 milliseconds, which doesn't sound terrible against this workload, but I am still seeing a bottleneck in running the particular workload. In fact, it did take about 16 seconds, which doesn't seem significant, but I'd like to find a way to make that faster. Now, from what we've taught you about deployment options and tiers, how to configure things, it could be that a different service tier or a different deployment option could get us faster IO performance and latency. But what if there's a way to optimize the application, maybe save a little money and just keep the same deployment you're at? So if you go back and look at the workload, again, you'll remember in seeing this workload, you'll notice that these are what you've seen before as singleton inserts. This is a single transaction running each insert. What if I could batch them? Let's look at an example of what that looks like. If I could change this to more look like this, where I start a transaction, I run a bunch of queries, and then I commit my transaction, maybe I can get better performance. So where I ran this workload, I have another example of the same exact query, except it's just going to use more of this batching concept. So let me kick this off and run and see what I look like and see my results. So I'll go back over here. I'll look at DM exec request again, and I don't have any results. Now, how's that even possible? If you go back over your workload, it's finished in 2 seconds. And if I go look at wait types, you still have log wait types from before. You still have the average latency because that was based on my previous workload, but my workload finished in 2 seconds versus 16 seconds. A significant improvement where I didn't have to scale my Azure workload. I went and did what I would call just some smart application tuning. Batching my transactions versus a single transaction for insert, a common workload pattern I've seen customers do. I significantly improved my performance for Azure SQL and just saved myself a little money without having to actually go to different vCores or different service tiers. That was a quick look at how to accelerate your performance with Azure SQL by changing your app versus your deployment. Look forward to seeing you in more videos on Azure SQL performance.